Hello and welcome to Town Talk. I'm your host, Rose Highland-Sharpe. This very inspirational program is brought to you by Highland Communications for storytelling, entertainment, music, and much more. Call 910-528-0718. Stay tuned for the highlights of Taylortown Juneteenth celebration held at the Bowler Municipal Park, coordinated by Mrs. Nadine Hedden Moody. Thank you to the town commissioners, employees, volunteers, vendors, individuals with their family stories, and history of a historically black township from Reconstruction, of course founded by the son of an African-American slave from slavery. Segregation, integration, the school, Academy High School for the African American students to now. It's a great program. You're going to learn about the community. You'll have tears and laughter. Thank you to everybody in your place and space there, from a place where I was raised and my four parents. Taylortown, North Carolina, USA, Juneteenth.
It's just about prayer. Amen. All right. Okay. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Now, God's been good to us, Lord, of over 400 and some years. And those of us here over 100 years here in Taylortown, North Carolina, I give God praise to the mayor, the town council, town clerk, everybody in their place and space. Brother Kevin, who works in the town, and this is from FSU, is that correct? All right, in the house, HBCU here. Thank you, Baylor State University. To God be the glory. Members of TCC here, from Representative Patel and Gandy family, so Barrett family, Williams family, Albert family, oh my God, Stroud family, and connected the Grand family. God is here. Amen. We thank God we're at the Johnny Bowler Municipal Park here in the municipality of Taylortown, North Carolina. Can I give some hollers and woo-hoo? God is good to us. Got Brother Jeffrey Moody in the back of me right there. One of his children, of course, is here today, and I'm representing the Highland and Ingram family. Let us pray. God has been good. Short prayer. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you for allowing us to be here on this auspicious moment, another year, the federal holiday, celebrating this 2022 Juneteenth. Remembering that time when our ancestors and slaves here in America were set free and they finally got the word that they were set free, made free. God, we thank you. And some of us need the word today that we are free. Free indeed in the Lord. God bless everybody in their place and space who gather here today. Those who work for this wonderful municipality, Taylortown, North Carolina, those who are part of the Taylor heritage and lineage, those who volunteer, the youths, and thus all the generations, and those who have gone on to be with you, God, thank you for the legacy of our loved ones who are with the Lord, God, with you in heaven. Lord, I pray for blessings on this program. Everybody going in, going out, those on the way, those who wanted to be here, those who are watching by the Facebook Live and the pre-recorded, have your way, Lord. I thank you for wonderful miracles and for success and prosperity, not only for this program, but the days ahead for this town. So we pray in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, in Christ Jesus' name, we walk by faith and not by sight. Amen. Amen and amen.
Good evening. Yeah. I'd like to start off by saying myself and the town council that we're glad that everybody came out to participate in the Juneteenth celebration. I think it's very important. A lot of people realize that Juneteenth is really starting to be recognized on the state and federal level. So this is a legal holiday. It's very important But for many years, people really didn't even know what the Juneteenth was. But thanks to the town clerk and councilwoman Rudy, they really worked hard on this program to try to bring to the front. So it's time for just enjoy yourself. And we have to report soon.
Yes. Thank you. And at this time, we're going to pick your program. I think everybody has a program. We can don't raise your hand and it's not a big deal. And we're going to have the song this year before we sing. And those that don't do it, you can sit down and sing it or stand up and sing it. But it's on the back of the program. Turn it over.
That was the introduction.
Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring with a harmony of liberty. Let our rejoicing high as a mist, let it resound loud as the world sings.
Emancipation Proclamation, more than 2 years after it was initially used Can y'all hear me now? I was talking about the news in Texas. Everybody else knew about it. It took me 2 years to find out about it in Texas. And reading other articles, previously they said it took them that long to get the word out. I read an article, it didn't take me 2 years. They just decided that slaves and bondage were here for 2 years. But however, they got the women and they were free. And the reason we have the different colors, red, white, and blue, and this flag right here, this is the original flag that was designated for today's celebration. And it was the activist Austin Ben Haight. He was the founder of the National Juneteenth Celebration Foundation. And he thought the colors red, white, and blue with the zigzag star as a special reason for the way he did it. Because when people were in bondage, we were not considered Americans. They didn't consider us human beings. And so he wanted us to be recognized for all the years we were in bondage, but not seen as being Americans, even though we were all over here, some were born over here. And so that's why we use the same colors as the American flag, red, white, and blue. And the star in it represents the Lone Star Texas, because they were the last ones to free their slaves. And the big first, the star that looked like it's bursting, that was for the newness of what we were going to see in our future. The red, black, and green together, that came from the African flag. It was their color. And so that's why they incorporated the red, black, and green later on in the late 1900s. They decided to add that to it because some people felt like they wanted to keep Africa as part of their heritage. And the red, it was red because same in this flag, all the blood that our ancestors shed. Black was for the color of our skin. And the green is for the wealth that Africa is known for. And it was left behind when they came over to this country. So that's the reason we have red, white, and blue, and red, black, and green. And a lot of the red is, I do a lot of red because the slaves, and I got these red drinks because the slaves, they could not drink any drinking of this stuff. The whole time they were in bondage, they made the sweet stuff for their masters that they were never allowed to taste it. And you think how many hundreds of years, they looked at this. They knew it was something sweet, but they never got to taste it. They said even the people who cooked in the master's house or whatever celebrations, they never tasted it because they was feared that somebody saw them even taste it, they would be killed. So for hundreds and hundreds of years, they never knew what it tastes like. So once they got free, that was one of the things they first did. They ate a lot of red stuff. They drank the sweetness. Like I said last year, the Kool-Aid, the punch, they finally got to taste it. After hundreds of years, generations and generations passing down, this is the red sweet drink. I don't know what they called it. That's when they said they started with the red velvet cakes, the strawberry cakes, the strawberry pies. They could never eat anything that was red and sweet. They only had to cook it and serve it to their masters. So whenever we are eating the red velvet cake, strawberry pudding, strawberry cake, just think about it. I mean, hundreds of years, our ancestors could only look at it. And I think about how they prayed to God. I was telling my husband the other day, I mean, hundreds of years, how many generations passed before we got free. Some people were bought here as slaves. Some were born into slavery. They died into slavery. But they never gave up. And they kept passing these stories down to generation to generation to generation until they got free. And it's just really heartbreaking to me to think how they had to live, how they had to work. They built this country. Our ancestors built this country, but they didn't get credit for it. This is 2022, and they still don't want to recognize us. They act like slavery was just like nothing. Other countries acknowledge what happened, but this country act like, well, some people act like it didn't happen. And for the things that our ancestors went through after slavery, they became sharecroppers. That was another form of slavery. But people did what they had to do to survive. The people worked them, halfway paid them, made them shop at their stores. And at the end of the year, I read that some people worked all year. And when they got ready to add up what they were supposed to get paid, they didn't get paid anything. The people told them, you owe us some money. They had to work the fields, plant the fields, but that was the way it was. They could not talk. They had to keep their mouth closed. And that's one thing bothers me. But it bothers me that people have a voice and don't use it. Some people can't talk. I can't talk. I don't mind talking. I don't mind speaking up for myself. I don't mind speaking up for the underdogs. But when I think of the years that we could not talk, it's no reason for us to keep our mouth closed now. People talk where they want to talk, but some people don't talk where it matters. You know, they can talk here, they can talk there, but talk where it matters. I used to tell my kids when they in school, respect the teachers. Respect the principals. Don't disrespect anybody. Bring it home to me and your dad, and we will go over there and talk to us. People have a tendency to disrespect our kids, intimidate them, and make them feel like they're nobody. That's when parents need to get concerned about speaking instead of worrying about going to get a Christmas turkey or something. Be concerned about your kids. There's a lot of people in Moore County schools. There's a lot of people on the Board of Education, and I don't mind saying it. It's in the pile of paper. Know who y'all are voting for. Know who you are voting for that Board of Education. If you don't know them, you can almost Google their name because it's going to tell you what they are for and what they're not for. Years ago, when people were running for office in this time, in this county, they used to come to this town to talk to the people, to ask us about votes. They don't care anymore. I don't know the last time a county commissioner, Board of Education member, been in our town to ask for our votes. They just assume you're going to vote for them. But know who you are voting for. The Senate, the Congress, all of them know who you are voting for. You need to Google. If you don't know, Google their name. It's good people in both parties. It's good and bad people in both races. But know who's getting your vote. Especially when it comes to the Board of Education. I've been to them meetings. I've seen how disrespectful some people are. And I go because of my grandkids. I go because of them. Because I don't mind fighting the fight for what's right. I'm not going to sit down and smile and say that's all right. It's time out for that. Our grandfathers and great-grandfathers couldn't say nothing. They had to take grandmas too. They had to do and say whatever the people, they couldn't say it. They had to do whatever the people told them to do. Because if they spoke out, they were in fear of getting lynched. You got people now getting killed for trying to speak out. You got people getting killed just because they're walking down the street and somebody else say, oh, I thought they were going to do something to me. Racism is in this country, and to me, it's worse now than it was when I was 13 and 14. But we all know the reason why people feel comfortable with it. So we as a race, we need to think about what our ancestors have been. Get together. Don't be so backbiting, stabbing people in the back and all that. It's time out for all that. Life is too short. life is too short. So that's not a pet peeve about that. But I just and at this time we're gonna have the song. I think the change is coming. And then we're gonna have a roll call of the churches and see if they wanna get a history of that.
Over there, she would give us some history. We know that the Gaines family were involved and several other families, and we'll have to fill in the blanks a little bit later. But one thing just represented from my side of the family, my mother's grandmother, Salina, some pronounce it Salina, Salina Covington Ingram. And so they were in Eastwood at the Free Will Baptist Church, and they came from Nova to Taylortown, one of those early 1900s and late 1800s, as it were. She was a school teacher as well. And of course, our granddad, daddy's daddy, Lawrence Highland from Clio, South Carolina. So we have a lot of these educators, but great-grandmother Salina was one of the founding fathers of Galilee Missionary Baptist Church. And so it still stands today in 2022. There have been a number of ministers, number of pastors, rather, missionaries, and it's a great church, along with the Church of God in Christ, Holy Church of God in Christ, and of course the African Methodist Episcopal Zion Church. So we're going to hear a little bit more about that. And by the way, just in case nobody else is here to represent, Spalding Chapel, AME Zion Church, Galilee Missionary Baptist Church, part of the PD, Missionary Baptist Education Association, Sproul Temple, Church of God in Christ, amen, and the House of Prayer, Holy Church of God in Christ. And we've had so many other people that came along with me, a little younger, a little older, who are now licensed, ordained ministers. Since this is a lot of folks coming into the latter part of the 1990s into the early 2000s. We all accepted our call to preach, and we thank God for the opportunity. But we've all worked together with the Taylortown Ministerial Alliance, established back, I understand, probably back in the 60s, early 70s, which was instrumental in this town being incorporated from those like Bishop Larry Brown and Pastor Johnson and others to get this town incorporated. It took some years, but thank God that. So that started from the church folks, amen, who worked hard going back and forth, I think to Raleigh and different places to get this town incorporated. For every family that's represented today and those who aren't, I love you guys. We all have loved one another, worked hard together. And I think about Brother Kevin sitting here representing the Bola and Utley family. And we're on the grounds of the Johnny Bola Municipal Park. A man who, my God, hallelujah, who would take those boys and with the baseball and softball, and he didn't have much of anything, but he piled into the car and got the uniforms and things. Since my brother, who just had a birthday, I won't say what that birthday is, and our sister who passed on to be with the Lord, won't say the birthday, but they were coming along and after World War II, the latter part of the 40s, the 50s, graduated from Academy Heights in the early 60s. And so my brother was part of the product of the Johnny Bola and the wonderful sports program, softball, and all the games that went on. This used to be a play hole, and the softball games and the hot dogs and the fun and everybody just enjoying each other on the weekends and whatnot. But the church folk, for those who are not in representation, had it not been for those missionary ladies and the deacons, the vacation Bible school ladies, the cookies, and the Kool-Aid ladies, what Elder Kenneth Stewart would say, taking time with the children, Mr. Johnny Bowler, God rest his soul, and Mama and them, so many, gone on with the Lord, and such wonderful friends, we worked together, and they taught us how to work together, right? Council lady, amen, lady, hallelujah. We worked together, babysitting one another's children, teaching one another's children. If you did something wrong, the church was, they would get you to before you got home. It was already known before they had all the, everybody had a telephone. You know, you had the party line. And then the party line and the CNN and the news was Melville Boston. God bless her soul. Come on now. And Miss, the Queen, Miss Mabel, Taylor Gaddy, and all the rest, Miss Pauline, amen, Williams, come on now. They got the word out, right? You didn't need the TV and the cable vision, the radio. You didn't have a cell phone. But the church ladies, everybody cared. People like Jeff Moody, Coach Moody, sitting behind me, professor. Amen, I call him professor, my school, my childhood friend. Mayor James Latimore Thompson, I'm going to put the letter on. So we all, and my older brother and sister used to babysit the man who's the mayor now. But between the church folks, neighborhood folks, and Joanne Scribe, father, babysitting, your mother babysitting Beverly's girls, each and one, so many connections. I look around and thank God for each of you. But the church folks, had it not been for them being obedient to the voice of God and doing what they need to do, we wouldn't be here today to celebrate this momentous moment. Thank you so much. Reverend Rose Highland-Sharpe. Oh, yeah.
Do we have any representatives from the House of Prayer? That's 14. I know we got Joanne from Spalding. I'm a Spaldette myself. I was raised in Spalding, Chapel A in the Zion Church. I'm a history. Not all of the history, but a brief history. Spalding Chapel was founded in 1905 on the other side of Highway 211. That's where everybody was. There was now families. He was right across the street, across the road on 211. But that building, the later, they also used Spalding. At that time, it was a schoolhouse and a church. Then they moved it across the street, but it's now Taylortown, where we live at now, for those who don't know. That building was burned and destroyed by fire. So they had to rebuild another church, a sanctuary, period. In 1913, the trustees of the church purchased the land where the church is right now. They bought it for $20. They bought the land for $20, and it was bought by Mr. Demas Taylor, from Mr. Demas Taylor's son, Robert Taylor, and his wife, Clara. And that's where the church is now. Mr. Taylor and his family, they were very instrumental in Spalding Chapel because they were Methodist people. But the church that's there now, that's the last one that was built, and once that one got built, they increased the building of Taylor Heights, building down the street, which kind of closed. But Spalding has had lots of ministers. They're in the Sample District of the North Carolina Conference. And I can say one thing about all these churches. When I was growing up, all the churches were together. We sang when we built the choir, because that's the way we were raised. That's just the way we were raised. Spalding had church on the first and third Sunday, and Galilee had it on the seventh and fourth. And I think the two Pentecostals had it every Sunday. But I can remember seeing them inside Reverend Sharpe in the Baptist church, and they come up to Spalding and sing because the missionaries work together, because that's the way Taylortown was. And so, you know, we have a lot to be proud of out in the town. You know, I don't look at the numbers of people that live in Taylortown. I like the quality of life that's in Taylortown. I'm not worried about having 3,000 people in my neighborhood. You have some people living in subdivisions, don't even know their neighbors. Neighbors don't even care for each other. And I like the closeness of our community. Like I said, we might be small, but we have big hearts, and that's the main thing that matters to me. And that's the way we were raised. When Reverend Sharpe was talking about Mr. Ronnie, we was reminiscing about the corporate, and I played softball with Mr. Ronnie up here, for those who are to believe. But I held third base. I was playing behind third base. I probably weren't that good of a player, but Mr. Johnny was the type of person that made me think, you were just like a pro player, the way he had me thinking I could play ball. I look back over it now, but I played because he gave me that confidence. And a lot, so that's why I say, look after your little children. Don't let people take that confidence away. When I was in school, Miss Allen Jackson told us, you walk with your head up. My mom even told me that. When you talk to people, you look at them. Don't hold your head down. You look at people when you talk. And that was one thing Miss Alice Jackson would get on with. She ran the class talking. She said, hold that head up and talk. Ain't nobody hear you when you talking like this. And I think that was instilled in our ancestors from the slave master. They couldn't do it. They had to be right there to start. They had to bow their head down. So that's why I said, the little children need encouragement. They need it. And I, for one, like, I don't want to see no child get mistreated. For no reason. I don't care the color of their skin. But you all see what's going on in this country now. You see how people people just shooting up places, and it's sad. When you take that child to school, you don't know what they're coming back from. That's sad. It's really, really sad. We go places, we don't know if we're going to come back home because somebody decided they wanted to shoot at somebody because of the color of their skin, or if they were from that they only announced nothing. So just because somebody don't like you for a reason, they just decide, oh, we just going to go make trouble for them. Because I'm going to tell you, when you do wrong to God's people, it's coming back. It's coming back. I'm a firm believer there. So lots of times, I tell people, I say, I pray a lot. Because the more you talk, I'll be in my knees. Because when you're living here in Taylortown, if it's a good place to live, in spite of what some people might say, what you might hear, Taylortown is a good place to live. It's a good place to live. Now, one thing about it, we might bump heads, but you let some trouble come in town, we all going to be together.
All right.
Be there for each other. You know, so, like I said, I'm proud to be a citizen of Taylortown. I don't want to live anywhere else. And I always tell people, you don't like what's going on in our town, as Apostle Andrea Weeks Parker said, pack your glad rags and leave. Don't keep fussing about, I don't like this, I don't like that. Go for you. I would live in a place that I didn't like. I would not pay a mortgage in a place I did not like. I would not. There's so many places you can pick. Want to go to that golf course? Want to go to that subdivision? All you gotta do is back up and leave. And let people come here that want to be a part of our town. They want to work in our town. And just be nice to each other. And before I close, I want to ask for possible weeks. But she's one of the ministers in Taylortown. Her church is not here, but I want her to come up and give the name of her church and everything. So she was a former Paul there too.
Right.
But possibly we would love to hear from you.
Amen. All right.
Amen. I'm just happy to be here. I'm happy to be a part of this Juneteenth celebration. I'm happy to be a part of this great community. And I do recognize and honor our Mayor James Lattimore Thompson, our Council Lady Nadine Moody, our Town Clerk, Rita Manus, and all the officials on our Town Clerk. I think I saw Councilman Sidney Gaddy. Mm-hmm. Yes, I thank God for all of you and to Minister Reverend Rose Highland-Sharpe, to everybody who is at this great celebration. I'm just glad to be here. And yes, I am a Taylortownian, if that's the correct word. I'm happy to be from this town. I could have built a home any way I wanted to, but I thank God that I wanted to live in my town and try to help build up my town. And I am a Spalette. Grew up there in Sunday school, Birth of Promise, Children's Church, whatever. Daily Vacation Bible School, and all of that. So your junior choir, even help the senior choir. And I still love Spalding Chapel, and I still help Spalding Chapel, and I'll help Galilee and Spurl Temple and anybody, because that's just the way our town is, especially when someone passes, we all get together, we make sure there's food or whatever we can do, and we just a loving town. And if you want to get in trouble, you say something about Taylortown to me, derogatory, and we're going to have a little conversation. But I'm so happy to be here today, and I thank you for this opportunity, Sister Nadine, and all of our town people. But yes, I am a Taylortown, and I'm happy to be here. I love my town, and I plan on going anywhere to live until I am dead and gone. God bless you.
Amen.
And before we close this part of the program, I want to thank Samantha and her mom for the vendors that we had. I reached out to people on Facebook, word of mouth, flyers, for vendors to come to our ceremony. You know, I'm a firm believer. We have who God meant us to have. They came all the way from Fayetteville to support us, to help us out. They came all the way from Fayetteville. They got beautiful t-shirts with a milk in the park. She has the little pouches.
This thing has got on all my stuff. I haven't got it all added up yet.
Mm-hmm.
But she has jewelry. I have jewelry that I've made. And the mom is selling hot dogs. I never knew a hot dog all the way. My hot dog all the way is mustard ketchup and maybe a little coleslaw. He got chili, cheese, everything on it. They are delicious. So we're asking you all, you know, we're going to be up here a couple more hours to come up here and buy some of the stuff because, like I said, I'm a firm believer. And I don't mind saying this. If you can't come to my town to sell something, I'm not going to your store to buy them. That's just the way I am. You're not good enough. Mayor Thompson, I'm saying this on my own, so people won't say Mayor Thompson said it. Nate even said this. If you're not good enough to bring that stuff into our town for us to buy, I'm not going to the store to purchase it. I'm going to the people who come to our town. So, Samantha, we want to thank you, your mom, and we're going to hopefully they'll be back here on Taylortown today to sell some more stuff because she ran out of some of the stuff we wanted. Yeah. That's okay. She has some backup. Because God always got a ram in the bush. And I think Miss Susie, the like Miss Susie Albert.
Come on, Susie. Yeah.
Oh, down Sugar Hill. Yeah. Won't you say so?
Sugar Hill. Let's see. Woo! Speak up, baby.
I was very happy to know about this celebration. And ever since I heard it, I said, I can't wait to get here to see what it's all about. So I thank God for bringing us here, and I thank God for Sister Rose Townshop. Take it home for us. We're asking you to
do it. Do it,
do it. It's not by the church, which I know by every church is supposed to have a poster telling you when your church was done. I heard you speaking of our church started in 1914,
mm-hmm.
and it was finished by 1928. And it's just wonderful to know how those pioneers were so happy when they saw Marlene's temple. She was saying about the people like the Sharps,
mm-hmm.
the Radcliffe, and the Bensons, and then all the others in between. And I say thank God for all of them who made the pathway for us to be much better. Mr. Foster, J.H. Foster, Ira Caldwell, and Grandfather Percy Alford, and different others that came along. I miss some of the main thing is it took all those people to continue. And my cousin, we were all well known in the end. That I keep saying to myself, I won't be talking of those, but when they came along, as my grandfather used to be, I thought he was a church one time to the church. And therefore, I guess I got that wrong thing. And I stayed in Juneteenth and feel like I was born in Juneteenth. Born in Juneteenth.
Mm-hmm.
But the main thing is God is good, and he's kept us this long time. And everybody, like she has said, the missionaries is Carrie Boston and John Alford's wife, Jesse Alford, many people ate that church where it was. And what it is today, we've got our modern day people. And so I'm glad to know and just like to keep our people in mind. The talking regions that keeps me informed, that keep her informed. So we just have the time to come with and we're just very happy to have this day to talk about our territory. And so that song that y'all played by Sam Cooke, I was born in North Carolina. And let's go to Taylortown. And the house. You know, God, I was born in a house where I'm living today. So my God has been good to me, Taylortown, and God has been good to me. I couldn't stop Susie.
Amen. All right. Yes, yes.
Is there anybody else that would like to say anything? I want to thank Mayor Thompson and the town council for trusting me and Miss Maynard to get this together. I'm going to tell you what. If it wasn't for this mayor and all this paperwork and putting all this stuff,
woo,
y'all would have just been up here, just up here. Maybe no 10 or nothing. But I just did not do a lot of business. But I give Mr. Maynard a hand.
Woo!
There y'all. There's a mad time out there. And Kevin, I'm gonna tell you, Councilman Dad is over there shopping, and that's a good thing. He came up here this morning to help make sure we got everything up, and Kevin and did. In fact, I think everybody did more work up here today, too, told except for me.
I know.
And I thank God for people who love me.
Oh, no.
They just came right on up here. And I want Miss Young to pick a bag up off the table. Pastor Weeks, you get a bag off any table you want. Joanne, get a bag off any table you want. Susie and Diane, y'all get a bag off any table y'all want. Reverend Sharp, get you a bag. And I think that's going to be all the two. Right. The people that work for the town,
give them flowers while we live.
We just give a thank you. Thank you all for coming to support us. We might be small in number, but we get as happy as we can be.
Yeah.
Everybody get a bag.
Here. Thank you guys so much.
much for tuning in to Juneteenth 2022 in the Taylortown Municipality, Taylortown, North Carolina. Thank you for the mayor, town council, town clerk, all the workers for this municipality, and for the volunteers, all the churches, all the youth, and everybody who participated. They're going to be coming on out today continually until about 6 o'clock this evening. So if you want to come out, come on out. Taylortown, North Carolina, right off of Highway 211. All right, West. And it's all good. I'm Rose from Highland-Sharpe for TownTalkTV. Signing off today, said every day, I'm free, free indeed, because of what the Lord did for me and what he's doing for you too. Take care.
Thank you so much for tuning in to Town Talk. I'm Rose Highland-Sharpe, and as always, I hope you enjoy the show. And honey, remember, somewhere by God's grace and mercy, if you're walking the walk, you'll be on Town Talk. Take care. God bless. Town Talk airs daily at 11 a.m. and 11:30 a.m. and other times noted in the evening on WYBE TV Spectrum Cable 3, Southern Pines, North Carolina, and on Rose Highland-Sharpe YouTube 24 hours a day. It is a service to the community.